We're at an inflection point with the power grid today. We're electrifying more stuff at a scale we've never done before. We are experiencing more extreme weather. We've never ran the grid as hard as we run it today. We've got to find innovative ways to provide these renewable energies and push extra electricity when we thought we couldn't before.
With the energy transition and all the challenges facing the grid, forecasting the future has just gotten a lot more complicated. The ability of AI to take disparate data streams and put them together into decision packages that allow grid operators and planners to be smarter in how we manage the grid really presents an opportunity. I'm AJ Hall. I'm the Portfolio Management Director in our AS New Energy Technologies group.
My name is Jessica Franklin. I am the Manager of Transmission Operations for AES Indiana. I grew up in rural Kentucky. Everybody knew everybody. In the country, outdoor adventures is what everybody does. As soon as I got a professional career, had a little bit more spare money, one of the first spoiling expenses was to get a motorcycle. Love taking road trips, going as far as I want. I've been a heavy metal fan since I was a teenager. Maybe that was some of that rage coming out, being stuck in the middle of nowhere. If I'm on a road trip by myself, I'll definitely put on the heavy metal. Nobody where I grew up was an engineer. I had never even actually heard of that term, but in high school, we had a professor come in, we did a little science experiment, and the challenge was to float the most quarters on the foil before it sank. I think there was something about some of the stuff I was seeing. That professor looked at me and said, "Have you ever considered being an engineer?" Yeah, that's where that spark happened. What keeps me up at night is a blackout. It's not just an inconvenience, your light goes out. There could be people in the hospital having a surgery or maybe they're on life support. So we take our job very seriously and we try to be as forward thinking as we can to make sure that doesn't happen. We have to make that prediction about how are we going to get the power where they need it, when they need it. With the new power grid that we're trying to build for this power-intensive future, we run different scenarios every day to try to make sure that we're not overloading the equipment. That calculation, just to run one scenario, can take hours, depending on the complexity of the system. With AI and these new data centers, we can look at more scenarios and realize more risk and make a more optimal choice about how we're gonna push that flow, because that calculation that used to take a day might just take a minute.
AES's goal is to accelerate the future of energy, and we want to do so with renewable resources. One of our strengths is actually partnering with leaders in the industry like Google to come up with new solutions that are going to drive the industry forward. Many people would think that we have a Google Maps for the grid, that you could find an asset and it would be easy to do. That's not really the case. Everyone has their own model, and the data for the grid exists in a lot of silos. And that's really what Tapestry is working to leverage. Tapestry is Google's moonshot for the electric grid and enables the visibility and situational awareness of the grid. With artificial intelligence, it's weaving together many disparate data streams across the grid from generation, distribution, and transmission, as well as from our customers. And putting them together in one model of the grid topology, we can all share and we can all collaborate on. And so Tapestry really enables us to run more scenarios faster. We can run scenarios for 10, 20, 30 years out, better visualize the grid and understand what capacity we have, what issues we might face, and reduce the uncertainty that we have in making those big decisions and how we invest and manage the grid.
These new data centers and the technologies, they're unlocking a lot of innovative ways to analyze data and they provide this new renewable future more efficiently for our customers.
AES has deployed one of the largest dynamic line rings projects in the country with 52 sensors across two states. So up on the pole right here in front of us is a dynamic line rating sensor that's looking at the sag of the conductors and monitoring ambient weather conditions in real time. And all of that data is going back to the screens that we saw this morning.
It's going to give us like a spatial awareness of That's how right. the movements are happening and whether or not it's getting too close to something.
Yes, exactly. It's another data point that we're bringing in to have better situational awareness. Building the most safe, affordable, reliable, and efficient grid is the aim of AES and the new toolbox we have of digital-enabled assets such as dynamic line rating or visualization tools such as Tapestry allow us to bring cleaner, renewable sources of energy online faster and really just enable economic growth and well-being in our communities.
One of our mottos here is all together. We go out occasionally, grab some beers. We will even geek out and get a little whiteboard and write down all of our ideals in between throwing axes or drinking beer. Resiliency and success in the power grid means we are better stewards of the planet. That means we're using green technology. We're not polluting the environment by using fossil fuels. It also means that we are reliably providing the electricity when the customers need it at the most critical time in their life. I always like to tell people I have the coolest job in the world because, quite literally, we're keeping the lights on. It takes a lot of dedication, but in the end, you know you're making lives better.